learned this morning, but what I've heard and seen so far has been really inspiring. And so for me, the idea of transplanted roots is just a beautiful thought and a huge question. And so when I was a young drummer, in my early 20s, I had what you may describe as a terrible case of notism. And so I felt that the content was what everything was. So I was a jazz musician, traveling around, having a great time, and the notes that I played were very important to me. And if you think of a tree, I thought the notes were the trunk. And but there was a problem for me. There was something in the sound I produced that was very inward. There was something about it that wasn't, something was wrong. And it was really bugging me. And so at that time I was sort of, I guess you could say I was playing the style of certain people who I was really influenced by. But if you really follow that flow, I was just copying them. And so I was copying a few influential drummers. And then I was on this tour and we ended up in New York. And the night before we did this recording there, I got to hear one of these drummers who I'd been just absolutely mesmerized by for years. And when this guy played, his name is Jeff Watts, his sound was so huge and so giving and so outward. And I realized that I was doing the opposite. I was very inward. I was more concerned about what the music was to me. Everything I was doing was about inward. It was a problem. And I could hear it in my sound and I could hear the difference in his sound. And so I was like, that's it, I've got to stop and figure out what this is. And so I had been traveling to Korea at this point for many years. I was touring there since I was 23. I was regular guest on numerous game shows there when they needed foreign face. And so I'd do that. I'd play on TV shows as a drummer, not just as a contestant. And I'd play at night with Korean musicians. And I'd heard a little bit about Korean music, and I was starting to, in the late 90s, I was starting to really get into it. Anyway, somehow, I can't remember the exact reason this happened, but I was having this conversation with this wonderful flautist, Korean flautist named Woo Hee in Sydney. Woo Hee was helping educate Korean orphans who had grown up out of Korea, and he was trying to educate them in Korean music. And for some reason, I was helping out with a visa of a Pan Sorusing. I have no idea how this happened, but anyway, it did. And for some reason, this I can't understand how this came up. My sad story of how I couldn't find an outward sound came up. I just can't imagine how that started. You know, talking about orphans and suddenly, oh, I've got a bad drum sound. But somehow it did. And he said to me, go to Korea. Go see my friend from the army. He'll fix you. And I said, okay, I'm going to do that. So I did. And I went and I had lessons with this guy, Kang Sun-il. He was younger than me. He couldn't speak English. He wasn't a well-known drummer. He's the best teacher I ever had. The most incredible communicator. His vocabulary is linked to words like terrible, so terrible, I cannot listen, incredible. Negative things. But I learned a lot from him. And so this period with him, this was in 2001, I had a lesson with him every day for 3 months. And we became good friends, and basically he showed me ways of thinking about how you use your body when you play music. And there's a really strong conception of that in Korea. Now, I had drum lessons from everyone. When I was younger, my thing was, I'm going to learn off everybody. Every drummer that comes to town, every drummer in town, everybody, everyone I can, and no one anywhere came even close to this guy's communication, and he couldn't even speak English, except for saying, so terrible, whenever I play it. Anyway, so, now what happened was, through this period of learning with him, I would have these lessons with him, which were in Korean hourglass drum, and then I'd run home to his little apartment, and I'd try and figure out how to do that stuff on the drum set. I didn't want to play Korean music. I didn't want to even in any way play that the notes associated with it. I just want to understand how to make sound. And so I spent a few years really trying to shift my approach to thinking about my instrument. And then I, through this film, I made some new friends. This film directed by Emma Franz. And so we met this great Kansori singer named Bayu Pond, and we became friends. And we're friends, so friends make music together. We started to play. And so to play with him, I had to know something about what he was doing. And his advice to me was, do the wrong thing with the right energy. And it's really good advice, because when I did the right thing, which is play Korean rhythmic things, it sounded really bad. In fact, I have really great memories of playing, trying to play right with him, and Korean percussionists sitting in the front row, just in hell. And so, what is the right energy? I know what the wrong thing is, but what's the right energy? And so what I came to realise was that the root, the trunk, in this case, is not the notes. It's not the instruments, it's this whole other thing. And so for me, in this, and I may talk about this experience in Korea, but I'll try and show you some other things as well that have come up for me. That in order to, for me, to pursue creative goals, there needs to be some kind of fundamental, absolute fundamental root to the whole thing. And I realised through that experience that I didn't know what that was. I had no idea. And notism, which is where I was when I was younger, can't be it. For me now, the notes are the leaves, and the trunk is all this other stuff. And so we're going to work on it today. And so in terms of thinking about transplanted roots, what I'd like to do is work on some things that to me are fundamental ideas about what music making is. The way we're going to do them is not the way you would learn if you were a traditional musician in Korea. We don't have Korean instruments, and if you did, they'd just get in the way. Some of you may want to play them, but I think if we do a Korean music class, that would be much more problematic. So the way we're going to learn is not the way you would learn there. It's a transferred version. It's not the way they would do it. But now, amazingly, I get to go back and do what we're about to do in Korea with Korean musicians. It's crazy. And so the thing is, if you're not playing that music, is there a way to engage with the fundamental, the root? What is it? And so if you could all stand up, we'll have a chat. So if you can imagine, an ellipsis. We've been doing this for a week, but anyway, we have to do more. So if you can imagine an ellipsis, like an egg, and it's coming out of your body like that. And if that's 12 o'clock, that's 6 o'clock, all right? And so if you could all, before we think about this egg, can everyone just do that? You've got to bend your knees to do it. If you do that, it's wrong. So that. And exhale. That. And bounce here. Can someone tell me what comes to mind when you do that? Like, what's that feel like? What does that feel like?
Fight or flight.
Fight or flight. That's weird, isn't it? Fight or flight. What else? How's that feel? How's that feel? Any thoughts? Nothing? What is, how does it feel to do that?
Like a relaxation exercise, a yoga or something.
Yeah.
Kind
of
movement.
Yeah.
Like dancing.
Yeah, dancing. Ah, okay. That's interesting. Can we try and dance on your floor? Don't do this. That's kind of dancing, although it's probably worked out. So if you just bounce here, okay? So you're bouncing on your knees, kind of. You're actually here. Anyone else? What? How does that feel? Do that.
Boxing.
Yeah.
Grounded.
Grounded. Yes. Anything else? One more.
Horse riding.
Horse riding. Yeah. Okay. Can you do this? Okay. How's that feel?
Suspended.
Yeah. Now do that. That is a different thing. Okay. So this one, that is the equivalent of how I used to think about drumming. I didn't actually do that, but that's what it was.
Do that again.
And pinch those two together.
Feel that?
That is not like this. And exhale. Okay. That. So that is the fundamental. That's the fundamental in Korea. And has anyone here been to Korea? So has anyone heard the word hogul? Anyone heard that before? So hogul means breathing, but it doesn't really mean breathing. Although you can say breathing, but for musicians it means body motion, body breathing, motion breathing, unison, being together. So if we could all just do that again, and exhale. And if you put one foot behind you like that, you'll feel your calf muscle, if you lean on it a little bit, feel that. And if you could try this, if you could imagine we're going to push out against this wall that's here, and when we do it, we're going to fall down like this. See that? So not this. We're going to go down. That's it. Okay, so that means for us today, when we go out, we go down. So out is not this. Can you just so you know? See that? So that is that. That is not it. So that's kind of out, but then try this one. Yeah, so that's core. Just try that one. Now try this one. Lift up. Lift up. Lift up. Lift up. So this is horrible. Beautiful. So let's do it. Let's keep going. But instead of doing this ragdoll, this is ragdoll, we're going to do this. Don't worry about exhaling, but I want you to fall up. See that? Falling up. And we're going to drop it 3 o'clock. And we're going to fall up. So when we fall up, it's this. See that? Now, here's the thing. No ceremony. This is ceremony. Check it out. Okay, has anyone been taught to catch the butterfly? Has anyone been in a boy band where you grab the butterfly? No ceremony. No catch the butterfly. What we're doing is lift arm, drop up. That's it. Lift arm, lift meat, drop meat. Okay? No ceremony. Because if you use ceremony here, if you do that, so can everyone just do a bit of ceremony? So that one, I'm lifting the arm. It's amazing. Yeah, so that means no core. Okay? Can everyone just do that one? See that? No core. Feel how it's all there? So a lot of drummers do that. I don't know why we do it. Has anyone here tried to drink a glass of beer and picked it up like that? Why would you pick up a drumstick like that? Yeah, so it's really important because it means what's happening in our body when we pick up a drumstick. And so the idea here is we pick up meat and bone and we drop it and it falls up. But when it falls up, it's falling slower than when it's falling down. So one. And if you could say, Kun. 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 And on that part, you say, Kun. Kun. No ceremony. Kun. Kun. Really fall from 3 to 6.
you say?
Croom.
Yeah.
Croom. Croom.
No shoulders, core.
Croom.
No ceremony. If you do this one,
croom.
It's not it. Falling arms, falling meat.
Croom.
Yeah.
Croom.
Inward.
Croom.
Inward.
Croom.
You got to come inward.
Croom.
That's it.
Croom.
No shoulders, it's not this.
Croom.
Here
to there.
Croom.
Croom.
Yeah, just cool. No shoulders, have a look.
Croom.
See that? No shoulders. Have a look.
Croom.
No shoulders. Here, face there.
Croom.
That's it.
Croom. Croom. Croom.
Now can we sing 5 to 6 o'clock?
Croom.
Five to six o'clock on our clock.
Ka-kum.
On our ellipsis.
Ka-kum. Ka-kum.
Fall up slowly. Four.
Ka-kum.
And sink. Don't use shoulders.
Ka-kum.
Don't you have to bend over?
Ka-kum.
You don't have to bend over.
Ka-kum.
On your calf muscle.
Ka-kum.
That's it. And
ka-kum. Ka-kum.
Just try 5 to 6.
Cocoon.
You got to say?
I've got 5 to 6.
On our ellipsis clock. 12, 6 o'clock. 6, 12, 5 to 6. 5 to 6.
Okay.
6 o'clock. And.
Cocoon.
5 to 6 o'clock.
Cocoon.
That's great.
Cocoon. to go to question every single action about what it is to be a drummer.
I had a problem, I just do that. Now, some of my stuff isn't in that rhythmic shape, so do another way. If it's a single stroke roll, you could always do this one a lot. It's incredibly time consuming, but it's interesting. So it's this one. One, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three, four, five, six, note one. Okay, so if you play like four bars of single stroke roll, you're thinking in this other whole book mode, and it's very interesting how much your core can be involved in sound production. So anyway, that was a transference for me of this core idea. Can everyone do this? Can you put one leg in front of the other? Really let your arm fall. No, and don't fall, think of bending knees when you do it. Don't fall ragdoll, but falling as an arm moving, it's not collapsing. You bend your knees, it's easier. Okay, and can we do this? Boom. Heavy though, it's a bell, we're trying to ring a bell. Kroom, 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 kroom. We're trying to ring a bell and the rope's there, so just grab it and pull it down. Kroom. So you can't collapse your arms. Kroom, kroom. Grab that rope. Kroom, kroom. Bouncing the ball. Grab it. Kroom. And it's actually pretty heavy, so you've got to use your core to grab it. Kroom. No collapsing arms. It's not that, it's a heavy rope. It's got a bit of tension on it too. That's it. And what you're trying to do is throw that bell behind you. So like this. Okay, now we're going to try. Kroom, 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 kroom.
Okay, beautiful. So that one has got everything for me.
if I want to ask a question about music, I go to that.
It's got low, high.
Coom.
Let's just sing low, high.
Coom.
Ka.
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 Coom. Ka.
Coom.
Ka.
Coom.
So it's got low, high.
Ka. Coom.
It's got long, short.
Coom. Short, long. Short, long.
Short, long.
Yeah.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
So, if I'm going to practice short, long, what am I trying to get better at?
Long.
And short. So, you just sing it. Seriously, if I want to get better at that rhythm,
boom.
Ha, boom.
What are my options?
More long.
Okay? So at the moment, the way you're singing, long is about this deep. So if we want to get more out of long, we've got to get more out of long. And you sing it.
Long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Right?
Short, long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Keep swinging.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Short, long.
There you go.
Short, long.
Short, long.
Okay, so we can get better at long. And long is killer. Like for drummers, ding, ding, da, ding. Long, short, long. How long is long? That's a big decision. Okay? Because it dictates the feel of the music. It's all about how long is the long note. That's the thing. Is it jing, jing, ja-jing, or is it jing, 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 jing? And we'll get to all this in a moment. But, so that one's got long, short, high, low, but it's also got call and response. Can we do it again?
Hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
ta, hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
ta, hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta,
hoom,
kukuta.
So if you imagine,
there's
hungry toe,
okay.
So it's got low, high, long, short, and call and response. So you can either learn the rhythm, or you can learn the idea of the rhythm. Tension and release, low, high, long, short. That's what that thing's got. Okay? If you just play it, you may never learn what it is. So there's a choice. So again, what's the root? Is it the rhythm? Is it the notes? Or is it these other principles? Foundational principles you can extract. Low, high, long, short, call and response. It's a choice. Okay? Now, when engaging with tradition, in many cases, the first choice is to just think about the notes, okay? But in Korea, there's a whole lot of different versions of that rhythm. So who cares? Like, the notes are, there's just all different ways to do it. It's the idea of what it is. It's beautiful. It's here, and it's there, and it's here, and it's there. A friend of mine calls that plus minus. Long, short, plus minus, high, low, plus minus. So, if you want to understand it and don't move, I reckon you don't get it either. So, can we try this?
Kum, kukuta, kum, kukuta, ka, kum, kukuta, kum, kukuta, kum, kukuta, kum, kukuta, ta, kum, kukuta.
That's pretty weird. Now,
kum, kukuta,
kum,
kukuta,
ta, kum, kukuta,
kum,
kukuta,
kum.
When you do that, kum makes sense.
Kum.
Yeah, it's great, and it's beautiful, it's actually there.
Kum,
ta,
kum.
Ta, it's 2 o'clock, that's where ta lives, okay? So you can understand it as a rhythm that you can sing, kum, kukuta, or you can say, what is the root here? What is the fundamental? What is it? It's there, and it's here, it's low, high, short, long. And if I move, I can understand it. If I don't move, maybe I can't understand it. Okay, so I feel like movement is the entry point to rhythm. You have to move to control, manipulate, do rhythm.
course, unless you use a computer, but still you have to do something. But there has to be a movement, really, to generate how do you move? What are you doing? If there's no ceremony, then it's a different thing. You're just trying to generate rhythm with natural movement. Okay? And so in Korea, it's a fundamental. But in Korea, a lot of people, the way they learn, they don't have to think about it to do it. It's inbuilt into the learning. Okay? But for us, we're trying to do other things with traditional ways of working. Perhaps we need to think about what's in it, not what it is. Okay? So what's in it is hogu. And in order to understand it, it's great to extract it from what it was and just do hogu alone, away from the music. Because I feel like you may gain insights into how it can help your music. Because a lot of musicians I know who are learning Korean music aren't learning hogu, they're learning notes. Okay? And this idea of transplanted roots, what are you trying to do with it? What are you trying to transplant? If it's the notes, for me, it's always the first option. And it's kind of easier because it is hard to stand there going, boom, boom, ta, for years to try and find out what's in it. So let's do it. Let me try this one. Can you all sing Jan Ji Jan Jan Ji Jan? Here we go.
Jan Ji Jan Jan Ji Jan.
Can we do that a few times?
Jan Ji Jan 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 Jan Ji Jan.
Okay, so that one hasn't got much developmental action going on. And there's this great idea in Korea. It's unreal. And what they do is they just insert a backwards bit to give a rhythm a reason to keep going. So can we sing that one again?
Jan ji jan 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 jan ji jan.
So it's not really doing anything. If we want to develop it, maybe we have to stick stuff on top. But if we insert a backwards, you get this. Jan ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan ji jan.
Jan ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan 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 ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan 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 ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan.
So that's a beautiful idea, and the way it was described to me is with a rhythm like that is play, lift, tighten, release. So jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan,
jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan. Jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan jan ji jan ji jan.
It's a great idea, and then you realize that if you just think that, it's enough. You can just go, jan ji da 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 da, jan ji da 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 da, jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan ji jan. It's like, this is great, and everything sounds like something. It's just like, yeah, that's kind of something, right? It's just play, lift, tighten, release. It's a great idea. And so they don't have to even match. So here's part of a longer one that kind of introduces this beautiful idea of same but different. So can you sing Jan Ji Jan Jan Ji Jan?
Jan Ji Jan Jan Ji Jan.
Jan Ji Jan Jan Ji Jan. Jan Ji Jan Ji Jan Ji Jan.
Jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan ji jan ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan ji jan ji jan jan ji jan jan ji jan. Jan ji jan ji jan ji jan, jan ji jan, jan ji
So for me, that's really interesting because it's part of a longer rhythm called chit chat. But that bit's pretty interesting because when you see people dancing, they're going jun ji jun jun ji jun jun ji jun ji jun. Okay, but jun ji jun jun ji jun. Can you all just do that?
Jun ji jun jun.
So they're fives. Jabba ji jabba jabba ji jabba. They're fives. But jun ji jun ji is six. So they're going jun ji jun jun ji jun jun ji jun ji jun. So it's longer, but it's the same. Same but different. So no one freaks out. It's just, it's an eighth note longer, and everyone's just doing that. It's fascinating because when we add an eighth note, what? How are we going to feel that one? What are we going to do with that? We've got 5/8, then we've got the sixth thing. What are we going to do with that? Who's got ideas? And then if you see all these people just going, jam, 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 5, 6, 5. It's like, yeah, just move. That's fine. It's just a little bit longer. So can we all move? Jam, jam,
jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam, jam.
So that works with anything. You can add a 7 instead. Jam, 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 jam. It's like whatever. It doesn't matter. It just feels great, this idea of same but different. So even from that one, we've got playlift type and release. In there, we've got this idea of just playlift type release, meaning we added a backwards bit. Junji, jun, junji, jun, jun, junji, junji, jun. Play, lift, tight, release. Got this idea of same and different. If you're moving, if you're not moving, it's different. Junji, jun, junji, jun, junji, 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 jun. If you don't move, it's a different bit. Can we just all sing that?
Junji, jun, junji, jun, junji, 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 jun.
It's weird, isn't it? After moving for a while, not moving is really hard. It's like, this is terrible. But I feel like not moving is always our first option. So, already we've just explored three little things in movement, and we've got this idea of lifting, falling up and down with gravity in an ellipsis in order to be together. And that togetherness actually is a piece of music called Tassarum.
Kroom. 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 Kroom.
Kroom. Finding a location for a note, it actually is there. If you just sing 2 o'clock, it'll be right.
Kroom.
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 Kroom. This idea of swinging up, now that's not in Korea, because they're playing instruments, but it's the same thing. It's a pendulum, and it's got the 2 o'clock there. If you learn to pull down that rope, you will engage your core. So there, for me, very clear ways of taking a fundamental principle and perhaps communicating it in this situation or in music away from the original context. But it is, for me, a very Korean idea, but maybe the way we're doing it isn't. And now I want to do it in a way that's definitely not Korean, but it's the same idea. Because we have different goals than Korean traditional music. For them, the music is written, it's done. And for some of it's been going for centuries. The goal is not to necessarily change it or rethink it, although that is a huge question on most of the musicians' minds that I know that they're trying to figure out how they move forward. And if you start with the notes, it's really tricky for them. So a lot of my friends who are traditional musicians are trying to go back to a whole movement practices to figure out how to go forward, which is really exciting. So this idea I've been working on to try and understand how to connect Hogwok, and this is a personal process, but it's based on this whole concept. So if you could all just, can you all just jump down on the spot for a second?
continue boxing. And let your hands bounce. Yeah, let's jump. Just let your hands bounce. And if you let your hands hit each other, it will sound like that. Attempted to engage with anything that's happened since Jay Dilla. Okay, so if you have this, you probably want to know how to do this. Where the beat sort of slowly. How would you describe that?
That's a very difficult word. Whatever it is.
Give us a go. Come on, what you got?
Lazy.
Lazy, yeah, it's weird, isn't it? I don't know which bit's lazy, but that's right. Well, how do you describe it? What's this broken
sort of
business?
Like a straight versus half swung kind of thing?
Straight half swung, yeah. So it's not, basically the idea is, can you all clap a triplet? You play the first and the last triplet. It goes like this. Cha, cha, cha. Just try that. Okay. And now can you clap an even one, an even thing? So, cha, cha, cha. Okay, beautiful. So let's just say, okay, that's beat one, that's beat two, okay? Well, that's beat one and that's beat one again. And what you just clap is here, into again. So cha, cha, cha. Beautiful. When you get that triplet, it's something like there, right? Then you go one and two. So let's see. Yeah. Okay? So this is like that scene in, remember that story, that movie about that kid that turns into an adult, they jump on the piano together.
It's a
bit like that, I guess. So here I am, and I have this could get complex. So I've got this half waypoint, and I've got this triplet, and then there's this space. Okay? And that's what you're talking about is, if I want to engage with there, I have to resort to metaphor. Lazy. Kind of half this, kind of half that. That's pretty weird, isn't it? I'm a drummer, and I really know this bit, and I love this bit. I don't know what's going on there. I don't have to deal with that. Let's look at that bunny's sun shining. So my question is, how can we know how to do that? It's not even, and it's not a triplet. What the hell is it? But can we all run on the spot a bit? You guys coming in because we're a drumming team. Oh, sorry, three. Here we go. So that is a natural pendulum. If I just let my hands bounce, I will get it. Thank you. So my question was, I love running. Okay, I love barefoot running. And I was thinking, how can I let... Finish?
1 minute.
Okay, so the idea for me was, how can I let running influence the way I play rhythm? And so when I'm running, I'm not thinking about steps. Can you all just think about steps for a second? Step, 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 step. So that's how a lot of us think about rhythm. But when you run, you don't think about the steps. But we think about the body. So you're thinking, bounce, bounce, yeah, chest, yeah, core, yeah. But you're not thinking foot, foot, foot. So there is a way to do it where you can explore all this by using hold. Can we just have 2 more minutes?
Yeah.
And so remember 2 o'clock, can you go like this? Kum. Ta kum. Again. Ta kum. Ta kum. That's 2 o'clock.
Ta kum.
So it's 3 o'clock. Three. Kum. Ta kum. 3 o'clock.
Ta kum.
Ta kum. 2 o'clock.
Ta kum. Ta kum. Ta kum.
Beautiful.
Ta kum.
Ta
kum. Ta kum. Ta kum. Ta kum.
11:30.
Ta kum. Ta kum. Ta kum. Ta kum.
Okay, so you just sang five different subdivisions with my four. You went one and ah, two and ah, three di ta, four di ta, it's 2 o'clock. Then we sound septuplets, da di da di, 1 o'clock, da di boom, da. Then we sung nines, which is 11:30. Gunga ding gang gang, gunga ding gang gang, junga ding gang gang, junga ding gang gang, chuck chi, junga, 1 o'clock, dum boom, dum 2 o'clock. Jungi fives, dungi da, triplets, three, boom, three, boom, three. So we can alter between all these spots here, okay, if you just think about whole hook cycles. Now that is not Korea, but it's an access point to understanding how to manipulate long short in all sorts of different ways that's removed from traditional music. Okay, so it's not just transplanting, it's changing by keeping to the fundamental, okay? It's not the notes, fundamental principles. So thank you everyone for saying that.